Welcome back, Alex. Do you want to talk about your time in Colorado? Let's start with something positive. What did you learn from your visit to Haven Springs?
I learned to let myself feel, I guess. And to not be afraid of those feelings.
Couldn't one argue that those old fears turned out to be justified? What do you make of that friction? I suppose I'm proud of you for trying. You helped some people. Chased a mystery. Got to kiss a pretty girl. But Alex, you're right back where you started.
I know.
Oh, you don't know anything, Alex. You don't even know you're not really here.
Oh, what a start. Hello, everyone. Welcome back again in True Color, and this is the last episode. Last, but not the latest. Because
what
we still
fuck?
Have Steph DLC.
I guess that's me. Case number 53322.
I still cannot believe that Jed just betrayed us like that. I trust him with all my heart. Sadly, he doesn't trust me too. But,
these
whatever.
Don't belong to Dr. Lin.
Welcome to your brain.
A tuning peg.
Good time to remind helping hands the scent that impulses to leave our institution. Why understand about our best assisted? Remember the outside world is trapped to it and possessed of an insatiable hunger. And you are soft and slow appetizing. Why throw yourself into his mouth? Throw yourself into instead of throw yourself into mine. I forgot to lead out this minute.
Hey, my guitar. Knock, knock.
I don't remember it being Alex Chen.
Is that what I look like? Really?
This Yuko reminds me of Life is Strange 1, in where there was Max like stuck in her time loop. Emotional instability, personal wavelength outbursts, hallucination, visual hallucination, all of Aura something. Delusional ideation, depression, anxiety.
Thrown down a... what?
Alexei feels a detailed and robust delusion that she is able to lead other people emotional state and believe that because of disability, she is uniquely equipped to help others overcome their own emotional trauma. It's difficult to overlook the irony. Sometimes someone as profoundly dysfunctional as Alex, adopting the law of emotional caretaking, has she not been returned to my care? I do not think it hyperbolic to speculate that her reckless attempt to add fixing her friends and family would eventually have gotten someone hurt. It's my belief that Alex's illusions constitute a threat to her continual well-being, as well as those of father. As such, I recommend Alex to be thrown down an endless pit, her body shattered against shooting bot and Alan Big, until she is forgotten in the darkness beneath the world. This is my professional opinion, the most human thing we can do for her. Pretty sure this is not Leo. Why would it be anyways?
These don't belong to Dr. Lin. Alex Chen? My guitar case has never heard of me. Sure.
I still haven't got out of the loop. How am I still not dead? God damn.
Oh.
Ah! Alex.
Gabe? You're dead.
So? Lots of people are dead, Alex. Most people.
Where are we?
I want to say a hospital.
Dr. Mendez to intensive care. Dr. Mendez to intensive care.
Yep, definitely a hospital.
Gabe.
Okay, here's what I do know. You are 10, I am 14. Our mother is sick, so is our father. But it's a different kind of sickness. Play your part.
Ow! Gabe, why?
I didn't do anything.
Stop.
Both of you.
Dad.
Behave. Alex, go check on your mother.
Okay. She was right over there, waiting for me.
Gabe, Alex, I need you to listen very carefully. We got some scary news today, and I'm going to be spending some time at the hospital.
What? Mom? Are you okay?
Shh. Hush now. It's going to be okay. Do you understand me? Things will be different for a little while, but I am going to be okay.
She knew. Even then, she knew.
What is this? One missing person, that's the two Alex. She was always catching the door, trying to get out, but she is too proud. So her capacity to fend for herself is minimal. If bothered, please exercise caution when approaching. She will appear friendly and normal, but we have some behavioral issue in the past. Please help me find my patient. You come, Alex. We're happy, though we're not surprised that Alex has one more submit to something. Alex Chan, age 10, sadness. Today we went back to the hospital because my mom is sick. I would never drove us there because my dad stayed the night with my mom. I want to bring my last shushu because I always bring shushu when I go to the hospital to see my mom. But I forgot. Mom say I have to take care of my brother and my dad. She used to not be skinny, but now she is so skinny. I wish she was not so skinny, and I wish she could come home. She gave me a necklace she wears sometimes. Should I let out of this? It's a lot. Okay, let's go. Crack. Chapter 1. Been in town for a week in his free time. Finding dad is what you did, because dad had disappeared from here years before. Move on to some new town, some new job. Gabe called County clerk, following up on a rumor, and for just a second, it must have seemed like he finally cracked the case. Our records show that a Mr. Why do they kill a Mr. Johnson? Was briefly a lesson of heaven's been cruel, but then it's such a shitty feeling realizing that you exhausted all your options, that there's no more gas in the tank. At first, all you can do is lose your shit, try to pull your foot through the wall, scream at a star, and hope to cause an avalanche. But eventually, when you're all out of anger, you gotta look at yourself in the mirror and ask yourself who you be after all this. And Gabe didn't have answer. Not yet. Gabe Lenchek shot the two. Gabe, God. It's weird to hear him like this. It's since the moment we reconnected. He's been so light, so full, but was empty when he got here. You can hear it in his voice, chasing across the country. Was all he had. Oh, he was. I'm pretty sure he slept in the park the first night he was here. And Jed never met a stray. He didn't want to adopt, couldn't help himself. He took Gab in, gave him a place to sleep just until he got his fish back under him. Just until he picked up the trail and moved on. Did he hope that Gab would stay? Did he into through the hollow eyes they kid valiness and I don't take handouts pushing that Gabe needed. Someplace new to call home if he was ever to feel like a human being again. Is that what he instilled about me too? Gabe got me. Chapter 2. He knew, obviously, styling at the ceiling. Remember Juvie, remembering Mom, me, us, Dad. I don't think he even knew what he would do if he ever found that. The cruiser just fired itself, offered him a sense of purpose, something to distract him from the gnarling hollow notion? That he didn't know how to exist in the world the way other people did. I think this was the first time he had a little conversation with Charlotte. I think he remembered it for a long time afterward. She looked at him with genuine concern in her eyes. Tried to identify what was broken and find a way to fix it. And all at once, it struck him that maybe he was fixable. That maybe someday he could be like others, like her, like Jet, like other people in this town who rely on each other and lift each other up. He wanted that, and he felt embarrassed for wanting it. I just want to grab him by the shoulder and shake him out like, of course, you can have that, dummy. You get fucking Shen. This town be ready for you. It needs you. But then I remember it. Doesn't matter who needs him. He's gone. Gabe chapter 3 dollar. It was a test to it was a test gave himself to something normal. A favor for a friend. Was a kid, so she can't learn some errand. That's the kind of thing you do when you're just another member of small town community, isn't it? And sure, it wouldn't hurt to earn some points with the cute girl who owned the dispensary. He really liked her even then. It's actually super cute, the mental gymnastics he did to convince himself he didn't have the biggest, tackiest crush in the world on her. But really, this was about being mundane. Just a dude who works at a bar. Sometimes not a sad sucks fucked up, diff the opposite thing over his suitcase a mission. And for a minute, he found that he was good at it. And that scared the shit out of him. Because after the first time, he could imagine if giving him up on that. It's like standing on the top of the building. And thinking about how easy it would be to just jump. You're not scared because you want to. You don't want to... You're scared because how little effort it would take for you to go out, to go from the self to unself. How few steps lay between where you are and the insane thing you imagine. What did it take for my brother to become a person he ended up being? When this is where you start, how do you find a way forward? Lion Umbrella. In my mind, I can see the lion paddling against her hailstone. The stone turns a little darker with each drop. The name engraved there, and Lucan. Mother and wife, a little more pronounced. Lion stated long ago that at that name during its death, so is that it stopped signifying what it used to be signify. Just Lion's curse into expensive log. His mom was more than a name, more than a mother, more than a wife. His mom was reason Lion feels so deeply. The reason he was unafraid to embrace and evangelize every doggy passion that he that captured his intention. It's hard to reconcile the 19-year-old in this memory with the guy I know. It's hard to believe anyone can start to feel normal again after something like this. I'm still not sure I do believe it. Oh my god, this is a lot. Lion Polaroid. Chapter 4. How Lion been there, bud? Just what the only thing he could make out through the fog. The only discernible familiar landmark in a stormy sea of a Jagger bomb. Jello shot and ridiculously alcoholic Colorado microbeer. So he clung to that, trusted him to get through the worst of it. And Jet did. Every time Lion feel like the world was going to open up and swallow him, just voice brought him back, anchored him. It makes me want to be that for someone else. Remind somebody that their feet are still on solid ground. Even when it's screaming at them that the opposite is true. It's making me feel like maybe I could be. I mean, it's also making me never want to do it again, but mostly that first thing. Mac. Chapter 1. I could do without Mac Phyllis. His skeleton is banging around in my skull. To be honest, it's such an urgent feeling, a lobe for around his neck, pulling him forward, compelling him, urging him to find something other than himself, to direct his fury towards. Every morning, this guy wakes up with the singing inaccurable, certainly that today will be the day. Lily came out to herself, realized how much better and smarter she is, better than him, and cut the cord. So it's almost a relief when he finds some external target to project his self-hatred out to. Lighty goofy bartender buddy. The one who's helping her to follow her dream of leaving Heaven's Being behind. He tells himself a slowly turns Gabe into the villain. And for at least as long as it takes to blow up in his face, and he can't distract himself from feeling worthless. I wish I didn't lead so fucking hard. Pike, business card, chapter 1. You know how you can sometimes feel like you are two people at once? I think Pike feels that way. A lot, maybe. He's Jason, and he's Pike. Dude, he's a doofus hanging out at the bar until the last call. And he's a responsible public servant who volunteers to drive people home when they had a feel too much. He's just some guy, a nobody. A subscription to managed gaming service and one of those Manila box club, and his cop with a gun and a badge and all the power that comes with those things. Sometimes, like, say in the middle of blizzard, when the new typhoon geologists get placid and called the number on your business card begging for a light to apartment, maybe he wishes he could pick a lane. Stay home. Have a drink in front of Jeopardy. Yell the answer at the TV, but urge to do a good thing. But urge to do good. To do his part of community he loves. It will always drag him into the snow. I don't think I ever feel that way about the place. T-shirt, chapter 2. It's fucked up how kids select the scapegoat, and it doesn't matter how pretty you are, how smart, or how functional, identical you might be to one of the cool kids. All it takes is one thing, a doggy shirt, worn on a wrong day. A moment of unstated intuition when detached chronicism is worked. A clumsy misstep, an utterly innocuous nothing that some little asshole latches on to and turn into your world identity. Cool, Lily. This dude was so cool to her that she thought about quitting. No more computer stuff. No more building things. It wasn't worth it. But then, and I still can't quite wrap my head around, this Mac showed up and treated her decently and kindness and respectful. Mac Lodon, who got suspended once for spitting tobacco on the floor of cafeteria, which, like, Lily Mac, come on, dude. That Mac Lodon recognized that Lily was extraordinary, and he went out his way to make sure she felt that way. But still, man. The shaving tobacco things, yikes. Lily, CIT sticker, chapter 4, living home helps. It's been so long since I have had a home. To live that, I guess, I forgot that you can't focus on the future. The hope and the excitement of taking that next big step, the relief of starting the flesh. But the pain doesn't go away. For Lila, I think home is Eleanor Mora, and it is her well-being. The town is just wood and concrete. A cobblestone, but Eleanor... Lily wouldn't be Lily without her. I think I understand that a little, or starting to. What I learned about Heaven's being, what makes me feel like maybe I fit here, is the people who made space for me. When I think about leaving them behind, even if I knew something better was waiting for me, it feels like leaving behind a part of myself.
I've never...
But it looks like Mr. John Chen left San Miguel County about 6 months after his arrival.
Yeah,
okay, I will stop at step. I mean, after I leave step. But an image shouted to the met in Seattle, a couple of queer punk rock girls drifting through the scene looking for comrades who wouldn't be spooked by their respective buckets. And they found each other, they called the band Dark Soul Makeup. Step on drums, easy on guitar, and a lot of noise for a two-woman band. For why, easy thought they would. They were in love for why Step tied to her, tried to be. It's weird to think that the thing I like the most in Step's enthusiasm, her ability to have a bright idea and commit to it. Her fearlessness lives in such a dead end for drugstore makeup. For her and Izzy, I can feel Step staring across the rooftop at her, wishing that Izzy was what she need. And I guess my heart breaks for both of them.
Me too.
You could stay here too. I wouldn't try to stop you.
Yeah, good. I'll be the only trans person in a town with a population of like 4. That sounds like a blast for me. Thanks for not trying to stop me.
I'm sorry, Izzy. It's not you. And it's not the band. I fucking love that shit. But I need to try this. It's just time for something new.
I knew it. I knew this would happen eventually. Fucking see you around stuff.
Vocally, chapter 3. Okay, well, that was pretty fucking adorable. From the second step lock eye with wow. That cat was hers. All her talk about calling Pike, trying to find for on a bullshit. Not like intentional bullshit. She really intend to do the thing, but deep down she knew this cat was her new best friend. Another wanderer. Another prickly punk log lady. With really particular taste in people. Also, super stoked to know Steph has a baby voice in her repertoire. Excellent back mail for Dumb Kid. Gabe looked at the show, he found them on the internet and got an access. Sent Steph a message out of the blue. Some stranger whose photo was seen in Heaven's Being. So they came, and they played to an empty room. White Gabe headbanged behind the bar and sang along to every song. And that's why. Is that Step and Izzy loved the whole thing? There was something kind of special about being united in their shared mortification, clinging together. Instead of clinging alone. And by the end of the show, it became a game. How hard can we lock when nobody gave a shit? If the best punk rock band in the world plays a show and nobody is allowed to hear it, do they make a sound? Okay, I will start with light here first. We will hear it again in probably a next circle.
There it is. The painting that taught me that art sucked sometimes. We couldn't afford a private room. Just got lucky, I guess. We spent so much time in here that I basically memorized every article. Gabe told me it was full of needles. Huh. Scared me to death. It was always too hot in this room. She's just on the other side.
Does she have cancer or something? That is super sad. Like, for real. She isn't well either.
How many nights did Dad spend in this room? Sleeping in an uncomfortable chair and eating vending machine dinners. There's something so weird and scary about watching your dad cry. Mom. Every time I saw her, I worried it would be the last. Hi, Mom. Mom. Mom.
Such a brave girl. How do you ever get so brave?
Is that how it went? You don't think you missed anything?
Ow! Gabe, why?
I didn't do anything.
Stop.
Both of you.
Dad.
Behave. Alex, go check on your mother.
Okay. Wait. Did I miss something? No matter how much Mom drank, her throat was always dry. We couldn't afford a private room. Just got lucky, I guess. Gabe and I used to watch cartoons on this thing after school. She's just on the other...
Forgot something. What does it mean? Forgot something. I don't see anything. Yeah, I don't see anything.
Hi, Mom.
Why do I feel like I'm gonna lose again?
Mom.
Water, Alex. Get her some water.
Thank you. You almost never cried, even when you were very small. Did you know that? That's been my biggest challenge with you. How do you take care of someone who is already so strong? My strong girl. I want you to make me a promise. Your brother, your father, they are going to need you. You have to be strong. Will you do that, Alex? Such a brave girl. How do you ever get so brave?
Is that the first time she can feel an order? It might be, because this power, created by or triggered by strong traumatic event, like Mac, who panicked so hard and was so scared that it triggered her power. Daniel, who was so shocked and so scared and triggered by those things too.
Was that the last time you talked to her? Mom.
I think so.
Do you miss her?
Gabe, what's going on?
You're 11, I'm almost 15. Dad and I are time bombs. You keep running back and forth, trying to defuse us both. This is going to suck so bad. Play your part.
Thank you.
there was only ever one thing to do when they got like this. Drown them out and wait for it to pass.
Good song.
Just me. But you know that's not how it went down, right?
It was my job to keep the peace. But no matter what I did,
hey Gabe, I'm Leslie Halloran. I'm from the Oregon State Child Protective Services. We got a call from someone who said there might have been some kind of fight here last night. Is your dad home?
Oh, gosh. You know what? We were... Yeah, that was like, rehearsal. And I'm in this play at school. And my dad, like, he was, helping me learn my lines.
Must be some play. But if you need anything, my number is on there. Okay?
Gabe used to steal Dad's beer all the time. It was like the one thing they didn't fight about. We never really touched these after Mom died. She was such a good cook. 2 cups water for 1 cup rice. Set timer for 30 minutes. Do your history homework. Serve. Almost empty. Almost always. I wanted to be a werewolf that Halloween. Couldn't afford the costume. I can't believe they were ever this happy. Mom's old sewing kit. Don't think I've ever even tasted a butter cookie.
My job was to sort them in order of how close we were to a collections notice.
Thanks for trying, Lucky Cat. It was full of greeting cards. Mom kept every single one we ever got. Cleaning Dad's ashtray was not my favorite job in the world.
I guess it's when I went out here because of Mom's death, right?
At least I managed to hold on to you, Shoo Shoo. Dad's laundry. I always set it here when it was done so he could find it. This was probably the most expensive thing we owned. It kind of kept me sane. Mom and Dad had this TV before they had either of us. Gabe had barely used this backpack in weeks. Nobody could get him to go to school.
Gabe loved Son of Lead back when it was an indie. It was too gory for me. The killer mistress tabs in this book weren't even close to right.
Gabe and Dad were so loud when they fought.
Where are you going? Are you gonna tell her? Or is that my job?
Keep your voice down.
Fine, I'll do it. Alex, Dad lost his job again. So we're broke again.
Don't talk to me that way. Despite what you may believe, you do not know everything. You think what? I laid myself off?
It's okay. We'll figure it out. I could,
I don't know, Dad. But what are we supposed to do now? We gotta eat.
We can sell some records. Or what about my guitar? We can sell that.
Alex, what is it going to take to get you to stop defending him?
Your mother could see you now.
I don't want to hear about Mom.
Gabe!
I'm so tired of you using her as an excuse to be a piece of shit. Don't fucking touch me, piece of shit.
Dad.
Damn it. Alex.
I'm okay. It's okay. It was an accident.
Alex, I didn't...
Dad. Dad, it's okay. Really. I'm not hurt.
I can't do this.
Dad?
Oh,
someone will
he
come.
That's
that woman from CPS. Someone.
Dad.
I'm sorry.
No. No. Dad!
Why did he just leave us like that? I don't understand.
Hey, can I ask you a question? Which orphanage is this? The one in Grant Park? Kind of thought it'd be nicer.
I can't do this, okay? I can't.
You need to.
No.
You need to be honest about what you see.
I was. I have. And now I'm done.
Almost. But not yet. You are 12. I am 16. I steal a car and end up in juvie.
Gabe, come on.
Then you're 13, 14, 15. Orphanages, group homes, musty rooms in the strange houses of foster parents. By the time you're 17, you've seen them all. Somewhere along the line, you start to feel things. Your own emotions don't belong to you. You have nothing. No one. You are alone.
I don't want this.
Alex. Play your part.
Play my part. I don't understand. Why can't I have my guitar?
We've been over this, Alex. Your guitar stays in the rec room. You can play it during free time.
Bullshit!
I don't need it in the fucking rec room. I need it when I'm stuck in the fucking dorms.
Alex, that's enough. Maybe we'll just take away your guitar privileges entirely, if that's what you prefer.
You can't do that!
How you holding up, Shu?
Can't believe how long you've had that thing.
That thing was my only friend after you left.
Guess I missed a few days.
I used to write one every day. Stupid.
Why? You clearly missed him.
And I thought he missed me. Hence, stupid. They used to say this place wasn't a prison.
Maybe they were trying to keep you safe?
Guess so. Whatever the reason, the end result was prison bars. I took a fork in here one time and hid it under my mattress. Just 'cause, fuck you. They should have stenciled the same thing on all of us.
You really feel like you were their property?
We didn't belong to anyone else, did we?
Fancy.
Everyone had one good outfit. We wore them to meet the parents.
Did it help?
Kinda think you already know the answer to that question.
I remember the kid who put this here.
Sadie?
Sally. Something with an S?
You were friends at first, right?
Way at first. Then I freaked out on her and she was done with me. Just like everyone else.
Everyone's feelings were so loud. I just needed something to distract me.
She's been through so much. I just don't know if we're prepared for a troubled girl. It says here she's sensitive. What does that mean?
I wonder why she's never found a home before. Sure, she's a sweet girl, but she's not for us.
She's awfully old, isn't she?
This is the kid that's been in all those fights, right?
I want to help. I really do, but there's just something
off.
Broken. Wrong.
With her.
So that is the little pouch. Much stronger than I thought.
I'm sorry.
Why?
You need to see it.
See what? That nobody picked me?
Nobody picked you. Nobody picked you. Nobody wanted you. Mom died. Dad left. I bailed. You couldn't keep us together.
It was my job to keep us...
You were 11 years old. You were 11 years old. You were a kid, Alex. Let it go. people leave. Life gets hard. Sometimes it's a big shit sandwich. Make it better. Be angry at Dad. Miss Mom. Hell, be angry at me. But don't give up. No one gets to tell you what you're worth. And no one can take your life away. Fight.
I'm not sure I...
You have a gift. It's something you don't even understand. You can change the world. Make it better. Now get up.
What?
Get up and fight.